Sam. How are you? So, I'm coming at you live today from my bedroom. So, as you well know, because you made the cutest video ever for my birthday a week ago from today, the 21st of November, I turned 20 years old. That's crazy. I'm no longer a teen, which is sweet. So, turn up, turn up. Not really. I figured that today I would make a video talking about all the things that I've learned, little pieces of information. Since I'm no longer a teen, I'm qualified to give advice, obviously. So this video is the 19 things that I learned by 19. Number one, call your grandparents. And by call, I mean call or text or visit or write a letter to. And by grandparents, I mean just the older people in your family. Because one, that's great to keep those relationships up, but two, there is no better feeling when you're having a hard time, when you're struggling, than knowing there's someone out there who loves you more than words, who's rooting for you to get back up again. And those people will always be your grandparents. Number two, most vegetables taste good. Like in general, vegetables taste good. Number three, this one's important. Some people you think are going to be really important in your life end up being not important at all. And that's okay. Number four, it is totally okay to buy something kind of ugly just because you know it's gonna be super comfortable. Number five, carry chapstick and band-aids with you wherever you go. I don't care if you're running out of the house for 15 minutes, bring them with you. Number six, if you don't like something that more or less everyone else likes, i.e., dogs, animals in general, for me at least, hiking, pizza. If you don't like those things, don't feel weird about it. Don't feel like you have to try and make yourself like them. Just number seven, don't be afraid to ask for help. Number eight, this one's really important. This one might be the most important in the entire list. I have like a list of people in my head that, like, I'm saying this to you. If someone truly wants to be a part of your life, they will make an effort, not an excuse. Number nine, if you have weird sayings or inflections or mannerisms or anything like that, own it. Because the people you spend the most time with will start to notice and they will comment on it. And if you're made embarrassed because of that, then that's no way to live. Just like second guessing everything you do and worrying about how you say things, like it's no way to live, so just own it. Number 10, the people in your life that are important, and everyone knows who these people are, like you know who's special to you. It doesn't matter if they've been in your life for a couple months or for 20 years, you know who's important, and don't take them for granted because they are important and they deserve to know that they're important. Number 11, if you have the opportunity to travel, do it. As often as you can, for as long as you can, do it. The world is way too big to stay in one place, and life is way too short to just do one thing. So, travel. Number 12, it's okay if it's messy. Your hair, your handwriting, your house, your desk, your thoughts, your love life, the other aspects of your life, it's okay if they're messy. Number 13, if it scares you, it's probably a good idea to try, within reason. Number 14, going to the movies by yourself is not sad or embarrassing or lame. It can be really nice. And I would recommend everyone try it because it's great. Number 15, don't let other people make the decisions you should be making by yourself. This happened a lot in high school. I'm looking at you, guidance department. Number 16, sometimes, and by sometimes I mean pretty much all the time, a really, really great weekend is worth the bad grade you get on a test Monday morning. Number 17, put your phone away. Put your phone away, put your phone away, put your phone away. This is something that I'm guilty of more times than I care to admit, but especially being in France when I don't have data and I can't just be on my phone at all times because that costs hella money. You don't need it. You don't need to have that outlet at all times. So put it away. Number 18, partying isn't fun. Like going out and staying out until like 4 a.m, just like, that's not a good time. And there have been times where I would go to a party and I'd be like, why aren't I having fun? Oh, because you don't enjoy this. So the moral of that story is don't do things because you think you're supposed to enjoy them. And if you don't like doing something, stop doing it. And finally, number 19, I will close with a piece of advice that my mother gave me. And it's the best piece of advice I've ever gotten. And she told me this spring of sophomore year. No, it's probably like winter of sophomore year. You remember this time, you lived with me, Sam. I was struggling, to say the least. Everything was just so overwhelming and stressful. And I called her looking for a little support. And she told me, after I explained the whole thing to her, the general told me to get off my ass and finish what I started. It's the best piece of advice I've ever gotten. There's no use in feeling sorry for yourself. Nothing good comes from just wallowing in your own self-pity. So get off your ass and do whatever it takes to finish whatever you need to finish. To get out of whatever situation you need to get out of. To get yourself into whatever situation you want to get into. Get off your ass and finish what you started. And when you are finished, it's gonna feel great. That's it. Those are 19 things that I learned by 19. At 19, by the time I finish 19, I hope some of these things help you in some way, or maybe you thought they were fun, I don't know. But I would encourage anyone watching to think about how old they are now and think about the things that they have learned and the lessons they have learned that have helped them get to where they are. Because writing this list was interesting. It was hard and easy to get to 19 things, you know? So yeah, it is Friday right now. I'm gonna post this tomorrow. And in like 3 weeks, I will be home. I will no longer live in the south of France, which is crazy. I feel like the semester has gone by so fast. But it's been so great. And I know you're gonna have such an incredible time when you're in Dublin. And yeah, I will talk to you so soon.